إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار يقول رب العالمين سبحانه وتعالى قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين Say, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم Verily my Salah, my prayers, wa nusuki, my sacrifice, wa mahyaya, my living, wa mamati, my dying, are for Allah. So, all my life, not only Ramadan, not only the Hajj time, not only the night of Al-Qadr, I pray, and this is for Allah. The life of the Muslim, the whole life of the Muslim, should be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we mentioned in this ayah. After every Ramadan, the Khatib mentioned this topic. What should we do after Ramadan? Because the wrong concept with many Muslims, we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan. Every day we are fasting in Ramadan. Every night we are praying Taraweeh. And we are giving a lot of charity. And the last nights of Ramadan, we do more effort in our prayers. So it means this is enough. We will stop praying at night, we'll stop fasting for 1 year or for 11 months. And this is a concept from the shaitan. No one told us that Allah accepted all of our deeds. Are you sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted our deeds, our fasting, our charity, our prayers? We are not sure. And also, who told you that worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only in Ramadan? Yes, in Ramadan, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to increase his prayers, his charity. But he did not stop worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after Ramadan. So, the life of the Muslim should be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan, in Shawwal, in the Hujjah, in the whole year. And also, very important, don't be pleased with your deeds. I did a great job in Ramadan. I am sure that I will be in the paradise. Some people like this, they think that we will be in the paradise because we did Umrah, we prayed, we did a lot of good, great and righteous deeds in Ramadan. And this is not the way of the believers. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about a verse. وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوْا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةً. In Surah Al-Mu'minun, Allah mentioned what are the criteria of the believers. وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوْا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةً. They did what they did, and they have fear in their hearts. Aisha said, O Rasul Allah, هم الذين يزنون ويسرقون ويشربون الخمر. O Rasul Allah, do you mean, does the ayah mean those who steal, commit zina, adultery, they drink khamr, they have fear in their hearts that Allah will punish them, Allah will not accept their good deeds because they did major sins? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no. لا يبنى الصديق هم الذين يصلون ويصومون ويتصدقون. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam answered his wife Aisha, O يبنى الصديق, the daughter of الصديق, the daughter of Abu Bakr, those people who are praying, fasting, giving charity, and they have fear in their hearts that Allah will not accept their deeds. This is the true believer. This is the true believer. He's doing great deeds, but still, he's not sure that Allah will accept my deeds or not. It doesn't mean to lose the hope, but it means to ask Allah always, Oh Allah, accept my salah. Oh Allah, accept my siyam. Oh Allah, accept my charity. Always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept your deeds. So, we need to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day, every month, every minute. وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Worship Allah until death. وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Certainty, it means your death. We are sure that you will die. So you have to worship Allah until your death. There is no vacation. You take vacation, for example, in summer from your job. But from the ibadah, from the worship of Allah, there is no vacation. I have to worship Allah always. They told the Imam Ahmed, one of the great scholars, until when you are writing the knowledge, you are learning. قال من المحبرة إلى المقبرة. It means I will still seek knowledge until I reach to the grave, until my death. It means I will teach, I will learn, I will write the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam until my death. There is no stop. This is one of the great scholars, Imam Ahmed rahimahullahu ta'ala. And if you notice, in Ramadan, people worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was used to give a lot of charity, more charity in Ramadan, praying more in Ramadan, doing i'tikaf in Ramadan. But at the night of Eid, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not tell us to take rest, stop, hold on. He told us to give charity, which is called zakatul fitr. At the night of Eid, before the Eid prayer, we give charity, the food, to the poor people. Then we go and pray Eid. And this is one of the great deeds, praying Eid in a big congregation. Should be the sunnah to be in an open place, to see the Muslim ummah in one place. We say takbir and we pray two rak'ah. And after that,
It is sunnah to fast 6 days of Shawwal. So as if they are, the Islam is telling us, don't stop worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Immediately after Ramadan, you give charity, Zakatul Fitr. Immediately after Ramadan, you pray, you fast the 6 days of Shawwal. من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه ستة من شوال كان كصيام الدهر. The one who fasted Ramadan, then 6 days of Shawwal, the month after Ramadan, كان كصيام الدهر, as if you fasted the full year. And also, after Ramadan, immediately this is the time of Hajj. Allah says, الحج أشهر معلومات. الحج in certain months, شوال ذو القعدة and ذو الحجة. It is the start of Hajj. It doesn't mean we go to Arafah now, but you can go to Mecca now. And you stay waiting the Hajj time. So it means the life, your life should be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, there is a very important concept in Islam which is called the tawbah, repentance. And Allah told us, as He mentioned subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Tahrim, يَا أَيُّوَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ تَوْبَةً نَصُوحًا. Allah asked us to make tawbah, to repent. And He mentioned tawbatan nasuha. What is the meaning of nasuha? They say it means a sincere repentance. Tawbah nasuha, with the, to fulfill the conditions of tawbah. I have to stop the sins. I have to intend not to come again to the sins. Because many Muslims take the decision, I will stop the sins during Ramadan. I declare my tawbah. I will stop smoking cigarettes. I will stop drinking khamr. I will stop cheating. The women say, I will start wearing hijab only in Ramadan. And this is not accepted. This is not an acceptable tawbah, repentance. It is not accepted that you intend to do the sin again after Ramadan. This is not a sincere tawbah. Sincere tawbah, you have to intend not to commit this sin again. The sincere tawbah, it means I will do more good deeds in the future. To ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give me more hasanat. I am helping myself to do more righteous deeds after Ramadan. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد. So what is the meaning that we should keep worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after Ramadan? Do we mean to keep the same level of worship? Do we mean to fast every day? And we pray like the Taraweeh, every night we pray 11 rak'at, or we pray tahajjud for 1 or 2 hours every night. We give charity like Ramadan. It doesn't mean to keep the same level, because even the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not keep the same level after Ramadan. No doubt he was increasing his ibadah in Ramadan. What should we do? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked, مَا الْعَمَلْ ما أحب العمل إلى الله. He was asked about the act most pleasing to Allah. قال أدومه وإن قل. أدومه وإن قل. That which is done continuously, even if it is small. Don't stop. Every night in Ramadan we were praying 11 rak'at. We were praying at the last 10 days 2 hours or 1.5 hours. But for example, after Ramadan, pray 5 rak'at, 7 rak'at, 3 rak'at, half an hour, 20 minutes, more or less. But the point is, keep worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Keep praying tahajjud. Don't stop tahajjud. Don't stop witr. Don't stop fasting. Adwamuhu continuously. Wa imqal, even the small deed. Fast at least 3 days of every month. Or at least once a month. Monday, Thursday, or any day in the month. Give charity. Do umrah. Do the righteous deeds. Adwamu continuously. In Ramadan, every day I was reading maybe 50 pages of Quran or 60 pages of the Quran. After Ramadan, read, for example, 20 pages, 10 pages, 1 page. Do something after Ramadan. Don't stop worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after Ramadan. And you wait the next Ramadan. So, the point is to keep worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and of course not the same level. It will be less, no doubt. This is normal. Don't accuse yourself, I was praying night with the imam every night in Ramadan, and now I'm not praying this much of salah. This is normal. And the last point is very important, which is, what do we need to help us in worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You need the good friends. Always the good friends. The righteous friends, as-suhba as-saliha, help you to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to do the good deeds. Allah told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wasbir nafsaka ma'a alladhina yad'una rabbahum bil ghadati wal 'ashi. We read this ayah, Surah Al-Kahf, every Friday. Wasbir nafsaka ma'a alladhina yad'una rabbahum bil ghadati wal 'ashi yuriduna wajhah. Keep yourself content with those who call their Lord morning and evening, seeking His pleasure. So the good friends, the pious friends, the believers, help you in worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah revealed this ayah about Bilal, Suhaib, Khabbab al-Arat, the poor, not the strong believers, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. Stay with them. Don't let them, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. So where are you? Where are the good friends now? Stay with them, visit them, invite them. Keep your contact with them. They will remind you the akhirah. If you know a friend who tells you about the akhirah, who tells you about the good deeds, don't leave this friend. And the friend who is always talking about the dunya, the money, the cars, the mobiles, the houses, business, try to avoid him or give him da'wah. You remind him about the akhirah. We need a friend, a brother, a sister who reminds us about the akhirah. Because the shaitan always tries his best to keep us away from the sirat al-mustaqim. Allahumma aghfir lil-mu'minin wal-mu'minat wal-muslimin wal-muslimat al-ahya'i minhum wal-amwat innaka sami'un qarib mujib ad-da'awat ya rabb al-alamin. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار.